it is interesting that when we look at us human beings, being given the intelligence, given the sense we have, sense of everything, including the sense to ask a question, who we are, it's a big thing. But when we talk of the senses that we have, apart from the sense of perception, we find that the five senses we all have as human beings. The sixth sense is, say, a little rare, but they say women have more of it, called the
intuition.
That women have the sixth sense called intuition. And they say that intuition works better than the five senses, that is why women have control over the men. I don't know if the women accept it or not. I must tell you, great master said that in the division of the roles in life of human beings, there was a division between men and women. And there was a gender division that took place not here. He said it took place when the mind was created. So the mind is different. He said that the soul, which is one unit of consciousness, there is no difference in the soul of a man or a woman. According to the physical description that they give, which is of course just a story, the soul of a human being has the light of 16 solar suns. So much light is experienced when you know your own soul sitting inside this body. But when the division took place, the male soul got more because of the strength and the physical form that the man took. And therefore, the division wasn't even 8 and 8, it was 12 and 4. But then when God saw, the Creator saw, this is unfair division, He said, I'll give something extra to the women. And He, what great master called, was a certain cleverness in their head, which no man can understand. And it can be used by them in many ways. The most useful way is to cry. I remember when I started some business here, when I came to the United States to make a living, and one of my partners said to me, I have a big problem. These girls who come to my life and I date them, they demand all kinds of things, especially fur coats and all that. And I don't want to give them fur coats. I try to lend the fur coat and then they give it back. But then they start crying. I don't know what to do. I'm overwhelmed. Then I have to give the fur coat away. I give a car away. Is there any solution to that? I said, I'll tell you a very effective solution. When next time your date starts crying, you cry even more. And I tell you what you will see. The girl is crying, oh, and you cry. What happened to you? Her crying will stop instantly. Because for one time in your life, you are using a particular gift given only to women. So that is why they said that there is what he called a special cleverness given. And in to make the word lighter, we call it intuition, sixth sense of a woman. But the seventh sense, I tell you, is more important than all the six in real life. It's called common sense. It is very uncommon, but they still call it common sense. What is common sense? Common sense is the ability to distinguish between the chaff and the grain, to distinguish what is important and what is not. We are constantly making a mistake of running after trivialities and forgetting the main things. Common sense, if you have, enables you to say, this is not important, this is trivial. Why am I bothering about this thing? These are so small matters. Why am I giving attention to that? That ability, if you have, is common sense, very important. So I always recommend seventh sense is useful. But the eighth sense is the most important. The sense of humor. The ability to laugh. The ability to laugh. Not at jokes only. To laugh at the very scene in front of you. The drama, the show. Look at the drama of life. If you take it as real life, there is no drama. But if you really know what it is, it's a drama, a show set up. Script written by you. You're the director, the script writer, the playwright, the actor, the audience, all in one. That's what the truth is. If you want to know, everybody else that you see in this world are actors created by you, by your mind. It's a show created. And you are also just one of the actors. When I say you created, not your body, not the name given to your body, but the one inside. You'll find the one inside has created everything, including everybody you see, everything you see, at every level. That's your real self, your inner self. That's why I say you created. So that is why when you remember that, you know that, you experience that, this looks like a wonderful show. It's got highs and lows. It's got all kinds of things happening. And if you can just imagine for your life that you are just sitting inside in a comfortable chair watching this show through these eyes, your life becomes wonderful from that day. But if you think you are the actor, you identify with the actor, you go through whatever is happening to the actor. Your body is merely an actor. But it's an actor like any other actor. So when I tell people you create things, they think this body is creating things. Not at all. They think my mind is creating things. Not at all. The body and the mind are the actors here. You are the creator beyond the mind. And that's the one that's creating everything. When your awareness goes to that level, you can't help but see this as a show. Till then, you can pretend it is a show. Some people say, is pretense good to pretend something? I said, if you pretend you have love and devotion for Master, it's good. If you try to pretend today, it will become real one day. Therefore, the Swamiji of Agra, who founded the Radha Swami faith, in one of his poems says, you have to do devotion, whether real or not, whether pretended or real, just start off with that. And even the pretension, acting. What is acting? Acting is pretending. If we act our part well in this show, we'll enjoy it because we are also the actor, also the audience of it. And that is why it's important to remember this is not such a serious matter. People said, give us the shortest mantra you know which has worked. Some mantras are very long. And I can keep reciting. Some Sanskrit people gave me a mantra. It took me a long time. I'll tell you an interesting story. I once worked with a politician. The politician had grown up from very small beginnings, but because there was no senior leader, was not taking the top position of a chief minister of a state, they decided to give it to him. And he had some traveling experience, but not much experience of governance. I happened to be the principal secretary to the chief minister of the state at that time. So when he joined, I became his principal secretary. He had never seen good life. He said to me, Mr. Puri, I think you are principal secretary, you can arrange anything. I said, I can arrange everything you want. What do you want? I want to visit Bombay and stay in the Taj Mahal Hotel. That is a dream. He could never have fulfilled in his regular life to stay in a 5-star hotel in Mumbai. Oh, that's no problem. I said, I called the chief secretary of Maharashtra State in Mumbai and I said, my boss wants to come and stay here. They said, we put him up in the best government guest house. I said, my boss doesn't want to stay in the best guest house. He wants to stay in Taj Mahal Hotel, Taj Hotel there. That's no problem. So they immediately arranged 2 suites in the Taj Hotel. And we went by plane, which was a good ride for him. And then he was in 1 suite, I was in the next one. And in the morning, we found that there was water flowing out from his suite and coming down the stairs. They were all carpeted, carpet staircase. And water was flowing. They said something wrong has happened with the water leaking from. So they had to break open the door, which was locked, and see the whole bedroom was full of water. Then they found that the chief minister was in the bathroom. And we had to call him please come out, there is water flowing all over. And of course, clad in a towel or something, he came. The worst hotel I have ever stayed in. I find they have no outlet for water. Then in Punjabi he said, no nikas in water. I've stayed in great hotels. They always have in the bathroom some way to water to go out. No such place. They put a carpet in the bathroom. And I tried, he said, I tried very hard because I use mantra. That's where I brought the story from. I have to repeat my mantra every day. And it takes me 1 hour. So I found there was no bucket. Nothing to take the water out from the bucket. So I took one of the, I think a flask or something lying in the bedroom. And I brought it. And I said, there's a tub, at least a big bucket. So I filled up the bucket, began to have my bath. So water was all going out, outside. Tub was getting filled inside. And in 1 hour in one mantra, one mantra in 1 hour, he flooded the whole place. Very successfully. So I said, please learn some shorter mantra. I told him. Then I found the importance of a shorter mantra. So people said, tell us the shortest mantra in life. I said, shorter mantra consists of two English words. So what? Learn the shortest mantra. Anything happens, so what? And remember, even the worst thing that happens, you will remember and know something worse could have happened. That is why, if you look at life that way, something bad happened according to you, something hurtful has happened to you, it could have been worse. If you remember this part, you will know that you can always cope up with any situation in life. These are very minor things, but they mean a lot in life. That is why I share these things with you also. And I say that the sense of humor should be, look at life and the humorous side of life. This experience we generated of this world is a very beautiful experience. If you want to see it in its beauty, there's nothing like it. Look at the variety of human beings. Look at the variety of actors available. Look at the way they act. How well they act their part. Do you know, when we find, there used to be cheap acting. People on a stage, we could go and see for a quarter, a show on the stage. And they were very poor actors. If a barber was asked to act like a king, he was still using his arm as if he's shaving or something. He couldn't give up the real life. But the people who wanted to act really as they are placed were rare. I remember a movie was made called Gandhi. Ben Kingsley, a British actor, acted as Gandhi, an Indian sage, an Indian politician. And he gave an interview in New Delhi, which I heard. In the interview he said, when they wanted to come for shooting, that I should be acting as Gandhi, I said, no, wait. I must for 3 months actually feel I am Gandhi before you shoot. Every morning he would get up and act like he is Gandhi. When he began to believe he is Gandhi, he said, now shoot. That means the best actor is one who acts the part exactly as he's supposed to act. And do you realize we are all best actors? Because we are actually believing what we are doing is a real life. Which is not. It's just an act. It's an act according to a script. But we think it's real life. Which means the very basis of creation has so wiped out our awareness of our own self that we as actors are thinking that this is our real life, therefore we are not acting. We are acting. We have been memorized, we have memorized our script so thoroughly. We don't even think it's a memorized script, we think it's our thought process. If you have awareness of this fact, if you know that we are merely actors on a stage, and great actors like, great writers like Shakespeare have said, we are all actors on a stage. If you just look at the statement, then, and remember this, we are watching this show, not as human bodies, these are actors. You are watching the show from behind the eyes, third eye center, comfortably looking at it. Imagine how beautiful and how humorous life will become, I can tell you. So that is why, with all my good wishes for the holiday season, and Happy New Year, I take leave of you now. I'll see you in January of 2020. Thank you very much.